Paris is renowned for its love of fashion, and that's no different when the slam rolls into town. At Roland Garros, even the spectators are critics.
I really like Maria Sharapova. I like the outfit with the stripes. I think it's very elegant. Yeah.
Okay. And very French. No?
Indeed. It looks like petit bateau.
Roger Federer, he's always the best dressed player on the tour, I think, and especially with his pink shorts.
Another Switzerland guy. I like him a lot, but I don't understand his shorts. I don't understand this kind of color. He's awful for me.
Tennis fashion has been cultivated on the grounds of the French Open for over 100 years.
How will a poor male be able to keep his eye on the ball?
The legendary René Lacoste changed the look of leisure wear when he traded heavy, long-sleeve shirts for the more practical apparel. Suzanne Lenglen was the first female player to wear shorter skirts, but the real revolution came in the 1960s, when Françoise Dürr was the cover girl for French tennis. The French Open champion was one of the first to use a designer for her tennis dresses and underwear.
This looks to be quite shocking, perhaps.
he was a little bit different, let's put it that way. You know, when you serve and your dress fly away, they should see something nice. So you should have a panty with a little frill and thing like that.
In the 80s and 90s, bright colors came into play.
The last revolution for us is the André Agassi in Roland Garros in 1990. It was a real explosion in tennis history with fashion. André Agassi opened all the doors.
Venus Williams decided in 2010 that less is more.
Everybody said, wow, what's this? I think that she had forget something. It was really strange.
Tennis fashion has become a multi-million dollar business, and sportswear companies have taken the lead when it comes to dressing their players.
Sponsors really give you the outfit and you don't have too much choices, so it's a big topic sometimes in the locker room, because sometimes you're like, yes, so cool, sometimes you're like, oh.
The 2013 Wimbledon champion says looking good on court can also give you a mental advantage.
I think when you look good, you feel you're ready to play better. For us, we're in our field when we feel comfortable and we feel confident, and you know, it just gives you this little extra thing that makes you think that the forehand is going to stay in the court rather than going out.